Well, we were all set to go on the car park. The Angels were en route, but obviously the weather has got in the way. But yeah, apparently the Angels will have been redirected, but they will join us at some point in the near future. But yes, it's good, isn't it, that we can come over Zoom and worship together. So let's think about these words that Jesus said. Jesus said, "Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy to bear, and the burden I give you is light." So however we're feeling this morning, whether we're amazed at the England result, or whether we're feeling low because of all the things going on in our lives, or somewhere in the middle, as we come to worship, let's pray together. Father, we come together to worship you. Thank you that through the cross we have peace with you. We enter into your rest. There's nothing that we can do to earn our salvation. It's a gift from you to receive. Lord, however we're feeling this morning, help us to worship you, to reaffirm our trust in you, that you are over all things, and that only in you can we find rest for our souls. So Lord, wherever we are at this moment, come Holy Spirit, fill us afresh, help us to know that we are yours, and help us to worship you, in Jesus' name, amen. Amen. So as we come together, let's sing our first song, which is "Come." Now is the time to worship.
Now is the time to give your heart.
Great words as we come to worship. Right, I'm going to do some clues for today, what we're going to think about. So if you're ready on the chat at the bottom of your screen, then there's a couple of clues. They're in black and white. I think the first one's fairly easy, but we'll see how you get on with it. So here's the first one. What do you think that's a picture of? I could turn it round, see if that makes it any easier. There's a few coming in. We've got wood, we've got log. Everyone else is finding the chat. A wood. We've got more wood, a fan. Yeah, it looks a bit like a fan. Some bark. Right, let's have a look. I'm not zoomed out hugely, but there we go. That's what it is. It is a log. It is some wood. So that's a clue, some wood. And then the next one, probably a little bit trickier. Let's see how you get on with this one. What do you think that one is a picture of? Oh, it's a bit slow on the chat. Oh, they're starting to come through. A waterfall. That's a good idea. Honeycomb. Bubbles. See if there's any more coming through. No, it's very quiet on the chat this morning. Right, let's have a look at what it is. Well, if I hold that up and I pop that next to it, I think you'll know that it's bubbles. So it's washing up liquid. That's another clue. So washing up. So today we're going to think about something to do with wood, and we're going to think about something to do with washing up liquid. So I'm going to hand over to Laura for the next part. So thank you, Laura.
Wait. Stop. Whose plate's this? Oh, it smells horrible. Oh, it's dried on. It's disgusting. There's only one thing for it. I'm going to have to throw the plate out. I can't go washing somebody else's dirty mess. That's so beneath me. No, I can't do it. Although it does remind me of something Jesus did. See, it was a time of the Passover festival, and Jesus and his friends were meeting for the Passover feast. Jesus got a towel and he wrapped it round himself, got a bowl and filled it with water. And he started to wash his friends' feet. Their feet! Oh, I don't like feet any more than I like that dirty plate. You see, feet, being in sandals in a dry and dusty country, they would have been filthy. It's not a job that a master would be doing. So when it came to Peter's turn, he was like, oh no, Lord, you're not washing my feet. No, that's not happening. But Jesus explained that unless he was washed by Jesus, he wasn't part of him. So Peter was like, well, not just my feet then, don't stop there, do my hands and my head also. But Jesus explained that if you're already clean, you only need to wash your feet, the whole body to be clean. That wasn't the only slightly odd thing that Jesus did during that meal. You see, he took some bread, it was probably a whole loaf and not a slice, and he thanked God for it, and he told his friend to eat it because it was his broken body. And similarly, he took some wine and he thanked God for the wine and said, drink this. This is my blood shed for you. Now, the disciples didn't really know what Jesus was going on about, but they would soon. You see, after they'd finished their meal, they went off to pray. And Jesus was praying for a long time. And then Judas Iscariot, one of his friends, appeared with some Roman soldiers. And Judas went right up to Jesus and kissed him. And the Roman soldiers arrested Jesus. They took him away. They interrogated him. They spat at him and whipped him. They didn't treat him very nicely at all. And then he was sentenced to death on a cross. Now, crucifixion is not nice. It takes a long time. It's quite painful. And people would come out to watch it happening. It was undignified, humiliating. But for Jesus, the worst part was being separated from God. He'd always been in God's presence, connected to him. But now he was separate and alone. Just before he took his last breath, he said, "It is finished." But what was finished? What had finished on the cross? You see, God could see that however hard humans tried, they just kept messing up. They made mistakes and they did things that meant that God could no longer be in relationship with them. The Bible calls this sin. And people, because of sin, were separated from God. Now, God kind of had a choice, didn't he? He could throw people away, just like I wanted to do with that plate. Useless, dirty, no good to anybody. But instead, God came up with a great rescue plan. He sent Jesus, his one and only precious son, to earth. And Jesus lived a perfect life. And he died a death because of our sin. You see, our sin, I hope you can see that, marked us, separated us from God. But through Jesus' death and resurrection, he took all the wrong things that we do, all the mess that we make in our life. And he paid that price for it so that we didn't have to. And because of that, we can be cleaned. We can become spotless. And we can have a relationship with God for all eternity. So when we do communion a little bit later, this is what we remember: that God loves each and every one of us. He came up with the greatest rescue plan ever. He sent his one and only son Jesus to earth. Jesus lived a perfect life and obeyed God even to death on the cross. Jesus paid the price for our sin. And when we accept all that Jesus has done for us and ask for forgiveness, we receive it. We become clean and can enter into an eternity with God. We're now going to sing the song, "Lord, We Lift Your Name on High."
I'm so glad you're in my life.
Morning, Mark. I see you're busy with your favourite thing.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, Andy.
Yeah, so Mark, can you not let go of it? I mean, let's go. Let's forget that. Let's move on. Anyway, what are you making, Mark?
I'm making something to show everybody, but I'm just worried that I'm not going to get it finished.
Oh, right. Okay. Well, you know, see how you get on. Actually, do you ever feel like giving up when you're making something out of Lego?
No, not really, because I like to see it completed. But I'm not always very good at finishing books, actually. I get halfway through and then I give up with books. And jigsaw puzzles, I just don't have the patience for. And if you give me a DIY project, I'm likely not to get it done.
Can you imagine if Jesus had given up, if he'd not finished what he'd come to do?
If he didn't die for our sin?
Yeah, if he, if he gave up and left us in that mess of sin and left us with no way of knowing God. Can you imagine that?
Well, it must have been so hard to do what he did. I'm surprised he didn't give up.
Yeah, it's true. Can you imagine leaving the beauty of heaven and coming down to earth?
But then in allowing himself to be put on the cross by sinful people.
Yeah. You know, it's amazing, isn't it, how much God loves us. That he loves us so much that, you know, when he went into that garden, the Garden of Gethsemane, you know, the one just before the cross, Jesus prayed to his Father and he asked him if there was another way that he could deal with sin.
How hard it must have been for God, knowing the pain that Jesus was going to go through and yet not being able to say, there was another way.
Yeah. You know, only through his sacrifice on the cross could our sin be paid for. But how amazing it is that Jesus was willing to do that for us.
Even though he knew how hard it would be.
Yeah. But even though it was incredibly hard, his Father knew that unless Jesus, his Son, went to the cross, that sin would never be finished. It would always be a problem, and no one would ever be able to be friends with God and enter heaven.
So the cross shows us how much God loves us.
Yeah, that's right. You know, when someone asks, how much does God love us? We think that he stretched out his arms and he said this much.
You mean by stretching out his arms out on the cross, he took our sin and died?
Yeah, that's how much he loves us. So, Mark, how are you getting on with your Lego?
I'm almost there. Just bear with me because I'm not very good at multitasking.
Okay.
Trying to read a script and do Lego, I'm discovering it's a bit difficult. Here we go.
It's looking like something's happening to me. It looks like you're getting closer.
Yeah. Also, it didn't help dropping a piece on the floor.
Ah, okay. Yeah. But, so do you think you're going to get it finished?
Yeah. Oh, definitely.
Ah, that's good. That's good. Be good to see what it is.
Yeah.
You got to choose the right pieces, I guess.
Yeah, that's what becomes difficult.
Yeah. Looks like 1115 from this side. I don't know whether that's what it's meant to be.
Oh. Yeah, I'm not sure what's going on here.
No. Oh, that's looking different now. Right. You're nearly finished, I think.
It's almost what we did in practice.
Yeah, almost is the word.
Yeah. See, if I turn it
round. Oh, there's something on the other side.
Sin.
So sin. So that's all the wrong stuff that we've done.
Yeah, that's right.
Okay. So that's what Laura was talking about, that what she wrote on the plate, that dirty plate, all the wrong things that we've done that separate us from God.
Yeah. And then if I turn it round, I've actually got finished.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
And if I do this, you'll see that we have the cross.
It's really interesting, actually, because sin is backwards in the word finish. And actually, when we turn away from sin and we trust in what Jesus has done for us, then our sin is finished. It's taken care of by God because of what Jesus has done. You know, when Jesus died on the cross, that's what he cried as Laura held up. It is finished. And that meant that all of my wrong, all of my sin had been paid for, that Jesus had taken the punishment for it all. So that when we now trust in what he did for us, when we say sorry to God for our sin and what Jesus had to go through for us, then God makes us clean. He washes our sin away.
What an amazing God we have that loves us so much that he wouldn't stop until our sin was dealt with and the way for us to know him was finished.
Well, thank you, Mark, for sharing your Lego with us. I think it would be good now to sing another song as we think about Jesus leaving the beauty of heaven and coming to earth to take our wrong, to take our sin, to pay for it once and for all as we move towards communion. So let's sing From the Squalor of a Borrowed Stable.
From the squalor of a borrowed stable, by the Spirit and the Virgin's faith, to the anguish and the shame of scandal, Savior of the human race. But the skies were filled with the praise of him. Shepherds listen as the angels tell of the gift of God come down to man at the dawning of suffering to save the lost.
The crucifixion of Jesus. Some verses from John 19. Then Pilate turned Jesus over to them to be crucified. So they took Jesus away, carrying the cross by himself. He went to the place called the Skull in Hebrew, Golgotha. There they nailed him to the cross. Two others were crucified with him, one on either side, with Jesus in between. And Pilate posted a sign on the cross that read, "Jesus of Nazareth, King of the Jews." Then the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and the sign was written in Hebrew, Latin, and Greek, so that many people could read it. Jesus knew his mission was now finished. And to fulfill the scripture, he said, "I am thirsty." A jar of sour wine was sitting there, so they soaked a sponge in it and put it on a branch and held it up to his lips. When Jesus had tasted it, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and gave up his spirit.
It's amazing, isn't it, to think about just how much God loves us. That, you know, when Jesus was on the cross, he was taking our sin, he was thinking about us, even though he knew what we are like, even though he knows that we are selfish, that we continue to commit sin. Jesus didn't just step off the cross and stop. He stayed there until the mission was completed. I love that line that Mark's just read. Jesus knew his mission was completed. And so after tasting the sour wine, he cries, "It is finished." You know, he went through all of that so we can be friends with God, so that we can share this bread and wine, knowing that God is with us because Jesus has done it all. That we receive the greatest gift, and there's nothing that we need do. Nothing that we can do except receive that greatest gift. So as we come to share bread and wine, we're going to have a prayer of confession, and then we're going to have the words of the Lord's Prayer come up on the screen for us to say together. But let's have a prayer of confession first. Lord God, we have sinned against you. We have done evil in your sight. We are sorry and repent. Have mercy on us according to your love. Wash away our wrongdoing and cleanse us from our sin. Renew a right spirit within us and restore us to the joy of your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So let's say the words of the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Amen. So before we share bread and wine, we're going to sing again, and we're going to think about the cross. We're going to think about the cost of us being able to share this special meal because of all that Jesus has done for us. So let's sing Light of the World. We'll never know how much it cost for our sin to be laid upon Jesus on that cross. But as we come with thankful hearts to share bread and wine, let's hear these words of invitation So come, here is the table of the Lord. We are gathered to his supper, a foretaste of things eternal. Come when you're fearful, to be made new in love. Come when you are doubtful, to be made strong in faith. Come when you're regretful, to be made whole. Come, old and young, there is room for all. So the Apostle Paul speaks about the Lord's Supper with these words: "For I pass on to you what I received from the Lord himself. On the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread and gave thanks to God for it. Then he broke it in pieces and said, 'This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same way, he took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it. For every time you eat this bread and drink this cup, you are announcing the Lord's death until he comes again.'" So let's give thanks for the bread and the wine. Let's pray. Father, we come knowing that we have been washed clean through the blood of Jesus, knowing that our sins are gone because Jesus cried, "It is finished." Thank you this morning for your forgiveness, because Jesus died for every single sin. Lord, we will never know how much it cost, but we're so thankful that Jesus was willing to die for us, willing for his body to be broken, for his blood to be shed. And Lord, as we gather around this table, may we know more of you. May we know you strengthening us by your Spirit. May we worship you for the Lamb who was slain for us. In Jesus' name, we give you our thanks. Amen. Amen. The body of Christ broken for you and for me. Let's share the bread together. The body of Christ. Let's take the wine as we think about our sin being washed away, the blood of Christ shed for our forgiveness. So let's pray before we sing our closing song. Let's pray. Father, as we draw near to you, we bring to you all those things that are on our hearts this day, whether it's family or friends, whether it's situations or places, we lift them to you now in a time of quiet. Thank you that through the cross we are forgiven. Thank you that our relationship with you has been restored. Lord, help us to walk by faith and not by sight. Help us to trust you in all seasons and to give our lives to you to serve those around us. Lord, we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. As we come to a close, we're going to remain focused on the cross, and we're going to sing a song as we think about serving Jesus day by day. Let's remember that Jesus chose the cross to serve us. Let's sing, "You Chose the Cross." So as we close, some words from the book of Jude. "Now all glory to God, who is able to keep you from falling away and will bring you with great joy into his glorious presence without a single fault. All glory to him who alone is God, our Saviour, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. All glory, majesty, power, and authority are his before all time, and in the present, and beyond all time. Amen. Amen. So why don't we close with the words of the grace? And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.